What is going on, Swoopers? Welcome back to another episode of Swoop Luke. The footy is back. Let's roll that intro and jump straight into it. Just before we do jump straight into it, quick shout out to the Fight MND cause. I picked up one of these beanies off of the website for, I think it was $20, and then, a shipping rate. But I'm sure if you go to Coles, I think Bunnings have them as well. You know, keep, 1.5 metres apart from each other, but you can pick them up for $20. You know, fight the good fight, and let's help cure this disease. All right, so during the week, this happened.
Our 2020 AFL Premiership season will resume on Thursday, June 11. All players and returning football department staff are being tested for COVID-19 prior to returning to the club. And that testing is continuing today.
The footy is back, which is amazing and great news. It was still up in the air, I guess right up until the day before that announcement from Gil. But there are a lot of rules and restrictions that come into place, the COVID-19 rules, as everyone is calling them. So I'll run through a few of them now for you, and we'll just have a chat about them. So there'll be no player spectators at the game. So what that means is if, Josh Thomas doesn't get picked one game, he can't come to the MCG or Marvel or wherever it is and watch the game. He'll have to be at home or, I guess, at the club. There'll be only 26 staff members, so they're gonna have to pick and choose, which includes only 6 coaches in the coaches box. And from all those pictures that you see last year and when it zooms up to the coaches box, there's 12 to 20 people in the coaches box sometimes. That'll be cut down to 6 on game days. There'll be 8-minute quarter time breaks, so up from the usual 6 minutes. 60 seconds post goal breaks, up from 45 seconds, so that there's enough time for the water boys to get out there, sanitize what they need to sanitize and stuff like that. On the bench is a big one. All the players and staff have to sit 1.5 meters apart, so there's no, high-fiving or anyone close to each other. Talking about high-fiving, during the game there'll be no high-fiving, no post-game handshakes, so no pats on the bum or anything like that. And during the team song celebrations, there'll be a social distance sort of, 1.5 meter rule as well. So you'll see like what Collingwood did against the Bulldogs in round one. What the guys can do for 4 quarters though is they can tackle each other into the turf, sweat on sweat, blood on blood, actually probably not blood on blood, but definitely sweat on sweat, getting all up in each other's faces, but they can't shake hands at the end of the game, which is a little bit, not even a little bit, it's pretty stupid, but I am hearing that after round 2, the AFL will look at these rules and maybe go lax on a little bit of them. I think, post-game handshakes and high fives will be fine if they are tackling. If they're not going to let handshakes and post-game, high fives and stuff like that, why would they let tackling? So I think as time goes on, these rules will get relaxed a little bit. So now let's talk about the fixture. So Gil came out and said that the fixture will be released in 4 to 6 round blocks. We should be getting the first fixture either by the end of this week or the start of next week, but it is looking like it is going to be a Collingwood Richmond Thursday night blockbuster to start round 2 and to amp up the return to footy. Today also was when everyone returned to training. If you go to my Instagram at SwoopLuke, you'll see all the training pics. Jump on Collingwood's Twitter or their YouTube for all training interviews with some of the players as well, which is always a good view and always a good listen to get their perspective on things. Another thing that I am not too keen on are these faux crowd sounds that Channel 7 will be putting into their broadcast. There was a 7 News update on the news, obviously. There was a 7 News update today giving us a sample of what they would sound like to me, yes, they're subtle, but it still sounds shocking when you see an empty stadium and then there's just one DJ going, oh yeah, ball, raw, bring it back a little bit less. I just think it sounds crappy. Just leave it. Round one was good because you could hear the players talking, yelling at each other, and you don't get to hear that otherwise, so just leave it as it is. So that's pretty much everything that I wanted to update you guys on at the moment. Coming up for the Swoop Loop channel, I've got a video that I'm working on about what the AFL will look like in, I think it's in a few decades time, maybe longer than a few decades. That's gonna be a little bit of fun. Also got a special secret video that I'm working on that'll hopefully get released before the games start up again. And on June 10th, a day before the footy restarts, I'll be releasing a new music video that's going to look something like this. Just a couple of quick shout outs before I go. Shout out to Cotton On for their AFL range. I absolutely love this. I think they're having 30% off store wide. This is not an ad or promotion or anything. I just really love Cotton On. It's where I get most of my things from. And also, I did it last time, but I'm going to do it again because I absolutely love this. CPJ Imagery on Instagram. Just amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. I will hang it up again. I just wanted it to, to show you guys a better view of it. And until next time, like, comment, subscribe, tell your family, tell your friends, tell your pets, double shackers, I'll swoop you later. So the footy is back, but there are a lot of caveats. Caveats? The fuck word is that? Which includes only six players. Oops. Always a good view and always a good read. No, you're not gonna read it. Always a good listen. Until then, like, comment, subscribe, tell your family, tell your friends. Fuck, what do I even say anymore? Fuck me. But until next time, tell your family, tell your friends, tell your pets. Shh, oh my god. And until next time, like, comment, fuck me.